Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about CTAT paper 2, classification of matters. Before going to start the discussion, I want to tell you that if you like the video, do like and share with your friends and subscribe the channel. Now let's move forward to classification of matter. Matter can be classified into two categories. There are pure substance and mixture. Pure substance is that which contain only one single component or substance, and mixture contains two or more substances. That is, we can say a mixture contains two or more elements or compounds in any proportion. Okay, that is about mixture. And we can further divide pure substance into two categories. There are elements and compounds. An element is something those have only one kind of atoms, and compounds are those have more than one kind of atoms. Okay, that is the idea about elements and compounds. Now mixture. As we all know, mixture can be further divided into two parts, that is homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture is this in which those have uniform composition throughout the mixture, and in which two similar particles attached to each other or combine to form new compound. That mixture is called homogeneous mixture. And heterogeneous mixture is that in which they are not uniform composition throughout the reaction. That is mixture in which every part has not uniform composition and properties as that of its component element are called heterogeneous mixture. Okay, now we can divide elements into further three categories. There are metals, non-metals and metalloids. I think we all know a little about metals, non-metals and metalloids. Let me tell you something about metals. Metals are those metals have their own characteristics. We all know metals are which make sounds and who have the capacity of transferring electric current through them. If we tell about the definition of metal, the element which have a tendency to form positive ions are known as metals. For example, silver, tin, zinc, etc. Now let's talk about non-metals. Non-metals are those elements which have a tendency to form negative ion to gain electrons and called non-metals. For example, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc. They are in solid or gaseous form under normal condition. Under normal condition, they are always in solid or gaseous form. Okay. Now let's talk about metalloids. Metalloids are those which possesses the properties of metals and non-metals both. For example, GE, silicon, etc. Now let's move to second topic. There is some important terms. Those are centrifugation, crystallization, chromatography, metallurgy, corrosion. Now let's discuss about centrifugation. This is a technique used in diagnostic laboratories for blood and urine tests, in dairies and home to separate butter from cream, and in washing machine to squeeze out water from clothes. Okay. In this process, these are the thing that we can do. And now let's talk about the second term, that is crystallization. The process of separation of a pure solid in the form of its crystals called crystallization. For example, purification of salt from seawater, it is an example of crystallization. We can purify salt from seawater, that is called crystallization, in which we crystallize the form of water into salt, that is called crystallization. And now let's talk about chromatography. It is the modern technique used for separation and purification of organic compounds, and the method was discovered by a Russian botanist in 1906, and his name is T.S. Watt. And botanist, we know that scientists who study about plants are called botanists. That is about chromatography. Now let's talk about metallurgy. The process of obtaining a pure metal from its ore is called metallurgy. And various steps involved in the extraction of metal is called metallurgical operations. Now let's talk about the term called corrosion. The wasting away of metals layer by layer due to the formation of metal compounds on the surface is called corrosion. Some examples of corrosion are rusting of iron, formation of green layer over copper, tarnishing of silver, etc. That is all about corrosion. Now let's talk about conversion of ore to metal oxide. We can convert ore to metal oxide by two methods, that is roasting and calcination. In roasting, concentrated ore is heated in excess of air. It involves conversion of sulfides ores into oxides and oxidation of impurities. And the formula is 2ZnS zinc sulfide and 3O2 oxygen. In presence of heat, we find that 2ZnO zinc oxide and 2SO2 sulfur oxygen. Okay, now calcination. In this method, the concentrated ore is heated in a reverberatory furnace below its melting point. In the absence of air, without addition of any external substance, calcination is mainly done in case of carbonate of hydroxide ore. For example, ZnCO3, zinc, and in presence of heat, we can find ZnO plus CO2. Now let's talk about atomic structure. Let's talk about atom. What is atom? We have to know about atom. It is the smallest particle of an element that takes part in a chemical reaction. Atom is a smallest particle that takes part in a chemical reaction. An atom generally consists of three fundamental particles, that is electron, proton and neutron. The proton and neutron are present inside the nucleus. The proton and neutrons are present inside the nucleus, while electron revolve around the nucleus and in closed orbit. So we get to know from atom, that is proton and neutron are always present in the inside of a nucleus of an atom, and the electron always revolve around the nucleus in the closed orbit. Okay, there are some things that we should know. That is, the particle electron is discovered by J.J. Thomson, and its mass is 9.1 × 10⁻³¹ kg, and its charge is −1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ C, that is coulomb. And proton is discovered by Goldstein in 1919, and its mass is 1.673 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. And neutron is discovered by Chadwick, and its mass is 1.657 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. That is about atom. And now let's talk about molecule. Molecule, it is the smallest particle which can remain in free state. Molecule is a smallest particle which can remain in a free state. A molecule has two or more than different atoms. A molecule can have two or more than two different atoms, that we get to know from molecules. And now let's talk about different atomic species, isotopes. Now let's talk about isotopes. The atoms of an element having same atomic number but different mass number is called isotopes. Remember this, keep in your mind that the atom of an element having same atomic number, the atom of an element having same atomic number but different mass number are called isotopes. Okay, same atomic number but different mass number are called isotopes. Okay, now, and for example, they are hydrogen, plutonium, deuterium are isotopes of hydrogen. And let's talk about isobars. The atoms of an element which have same mass number and different atomic number are called isobars. The atoms of an element which have same mass number and different atomic number are called isobars. Isobars are those which have same mass number and different atomic number. Okay, now let's talk about isotones. An example of isobar is argon and calcium. Isotones are atoms have same number of electrons, same number of electrons but different atomic number as well as mass number are called isotones. Same mass, same number of neutrons but different number of, but different atomic number as well as mass number are called isotones. That is all about today. Hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching.